Jerry strolled into the Klarna convenience store down the street from his house. Ronald, the owner of the store, smiled at him.
What's up, man? The usual?
Jerry looked at the lottery tickets under the glass.
I don't know. I'm bored of the same old thing. I need something different.
Ronald pointed down further down the counter to a stack of black tickets.
They came out with a new one today. Only $3.
Jerry shrugged.
Sure, why not?
Ronald unlocked the cabinet.
I hope you don't mind me asking. After all, it's customers like you that keep me in business, but do you really think you should spend so much on lottery tickets? I don't even remember the last time you won anything.
Jerry sighed.
Still have a better chance of winning the lottery than I do of ever being able to afford to retire.
Ronald's brow furrowed as he removed the ticket.
Really? Aren't you a professional? Your house seems awfully nice.
Jerry smiled sadly.
It's a rental, and being an American computer programmer has been a miserable experience since the dot-com bubble.
Ronald locked up the cabinet.
Wasn't that a long time ago?
No, that was just the beginning. That was followed by the outsourcing phenomenon, the guest worker phenomenon, and now the perfect fit phenomenon. Either your experience matches every last point on their mind-numbingly long list of requirements, or they don't even get back to you.
Ronald handed Jerry the ticket.
That rots, man. Ever thought of starting your own business?
Jerry cringed.
I don't have the people skills for that. That's why I ended up programming computers in the first place.
Ronald looked sympathetic as Jerry began scratching off a row of 5 ink dots.
Sorry to hear that, man. Hope your luck changes.
Jerry finished scratching a row. He gawked at the ticket.
What the? All 5 say death.
What?
Ronald grabbed the ticket and stared at it, gaping.
Whoa, that's new.
Without warning, a dark, swirling vortex opened up in the middle of the room. Jerry felt it pulling on him. Ronald's eyes grew wide.
That's new too.
What kind of tickets are these?
Jerry looked uneasy.
Come to think of it, it wasn't the normal guy today. This one wore all black and a top hat, and he carried a white cane and was unnaturally tall. I just thought it was some sort of promotion.
Jerry furiously scratched off the rest of the ink dots. Ronald cheered him on.
Yeah, invalidate it. That ought to work.
It didn't. The rest of the spaces also said death, and the vortex pulled at Jerry even more strongly. Ronald was at a loss.
Oh, I'll call the helpline.
Jerry smiled sanguinely.
No need. I've decided to accept my prize.
Ronald gaped at Jerry.
What? Why?
Jerry flashed Ronald a peaceful grin.
I no longer have to worry about paying for retirement. I don't have to go back to my blood-sucking job.
The vortex pulled Jerry in. Jerry laughed before he vanished.
It really is my lucky day.